opportunity in 3 weeks at WWE Fastlane, because if he beats Jey Uso tonight, that's what Bryan's going to earn.
You know that is a mighty big if.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 242 pounds, Jey Uso!
Again, high-stakes matchup for Daniel Bryan here tonight. An opportunity to earn a legitimate shot at the Universal Championship. And tonight, Friday Night SmackDown on Fox is sponsored by Progressive Insurance. Save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance.
Well, how dare you question the legitimacy of Roman Reigns' Universal Championship defense at Elimination Chamber? Yes, Daniel Bryan just competed in a grueling chamber match, but Roman Reigns didn't have time to prepare for a specific opponent. Roman had to face basically the luck of the draw. And you think the stakes aren't high for Jey Uso? You think Roman's going to be happy with Jey if Jey somehow lets Daniel slip past the gates?
And Uso and Bryan now going right at it as the matchup is underway. Daniel Bryan, Corey, entered the Elimination Chamber match as one of the first two men. He was in the match over 30 minutes, beaten down before Roman Reigns came out to take advantage and have his championship opportunity immediately following the chamber.
And Daniel Bryan deserves the accolades and the adulation of what he did this past Sunday. But we say it time and time again, almost only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades.
Now Daniel Bryan continues to work on the arm of Uso.
Daniel now delivering a kick with his left leg, which seems to be holding up fairly well despite all the battle wounds he endured this past Sunday inside the Elimination Chamber.
Yeah, Bryan has suffered a lot of trauma to the left knee during the Elimination Chamber match. You see it heavily taped here as he continues to control Jey Uso. Daniel Bryan called Roman Reigns' actions, or he said some people would call Roman Reigns' actions, cowardly this past Sunday.
Daniel, notice he grasped at his left leg for a moment there.
But down goes Uso.
Again, adrenaline. Daniel Bryan's best friend being able to fight through the pain, fight through the agony, keeping his eye on the prize.
Well, he understands what is at stake, an opportunity to battle for the Universal Championship at Fastlane 3 weeks from Sunday against Reigns. And you beat Reigns at Fastlane, you're going to main event WrestleMania.
And again, it's with this foregone conclusion that Daniel Bryan's going to get past Jey Uso. This is main event Jey we're talking about, okay?
Nobody's saying it's a foregone conclusion.
You're talking like it's a foregone conclusion.
No, I'm setting the stakes for what this match means for Bryan. And Uso now placed up on the second rope. Long history between these two. Remember, a Jey Uso splash off the top rope through the announce table cost Daniel Bryan a number of weeks of his career. Bryan now cover on Uso. Is it enough to win the match? Almost had him near fall.
And you keep bringing up the match with Roman Reigns this past Sunday as though, as we take another look at this, Daniel Bryan's spectacular athleticism, Hurricane Rana from the top, as though Daniel Bryan didn't nearly defeat Roman Reigns. Bryan was able to lock in the yes lock.
Yes, he was after a great drop toe hold at the start of the matchup.
But Daniel Bryan
did that on instinct alone, Corey. He was in no shape to compete in that match. You know it.
Well, Roman Reigns was competing on instinct alone. He was able to escape and batter his challenger.
And meanwhile, now Daniel Bryan going to fly. Bryan
kick. Oh, man. Right on the money. Jey Uso stopping Bryan dead in his tracks.
Now the dangerous Uso, the back knee right on the announce table, and Bryan screaming in pain.
Daniel Bryan may get counted out.
Uso wants to do more damage. He wants to teach Daniel Bryan a lesson in his mind. And now bad knee again.